Hello, this is Angra Waki based in the United States. Thank you for watching my video and supporting my channel. From the West Coast, I upload fishing videos every week, introducing how to fish in the Japanese way using popular techniques in Japan and Japanese fishing gear. Last month, I went to Tokyo, Japan. My home country, my hometown, home sweet home. It was nice seeing my family there and spending time with them. It was not my private trip, it was for my job. No fishing, of course. Business meetings after business meetings, super busy days I had. But somehow, I could manage time to hit a fishing tackle shop. Yes! In this video, I'd like to show you something you may have never seen. The world of Gary Yamamoto in Japan. Probably many of you would be surprised. Let's check it out. When we talk about Gary Yamamoto's success story, we cannot avoid his story with Japan. In the early days of Gary Yamamoto, they were just a small local company on the West Coast. Then, he looked at Japan as a new market. At that time in Japan, a big bass fishing fever was coming. He introduced a new fishing style using Gary Yamamoto's glove, and it immediately became all Japanese bass anglers standards. I'll say it's because his lure was great, but also the name, Gary Yamamoto, could sound familiar to us. As you may know, he's a Japanese-American. His parents are immigrants to the United States. I mean, he has his family root in Japan. Yamamoto is a very common family name. We have many Yamamoto-san in Japan. So, I can say, Gary Yamamoto and Japan have had a strong bond from the beginning. Here you go! These yellow packages are all Gary Yamamoto baits. In Japan, we have three retailers, Gary International, Smith, and Timico. I believe Smith and Timico were the first companies who introduced Yamamoto baits to Japan. Then, when Gary came to Japan, Gary International was founded. Now, these three companies handled tons of Gary Yamamoto products that you may have never seen. I mean, in Japan, we have many Japan-only Gary Yamamoto baits. I honestly have no idea what impact would come from the Yamamoto baits acquisition happened in the United States. I just hope nothing happens for Japanese products. Fingers crossed. Okay, let me introduce some of them to you. The first one. This is Gary Yamamoto Legworm. This is by Gary International. A popular lure for the dropshot rig in Japan. Well known as a Japanese famous bass pro, Tsuguhiko Komori's killer weapon. He has won many tournaments using this worm. A ribbed body and a bulky shad tail. The shape looks like a leg. So that this is named Legworm. The tail makes strong action pushing the water. When jerking it, the body weight makes it just stop right still. This makes this worm the one and only shad tail worm. This is what the official website said. Two sizes are available, 2.5 and 2.9 inches. I use this with a drop shot rig and jig head. A nice warm hold the Japanese finesse style. This is tailless emo grab. We Japanese simply call this emo grab. I believe this is by Smith, one of the Gary Yamamoto retailers in Japan. I mean, Smith custom ordered this worm to Gary Yamamoto Custom Baits. In Japan, anglers cut the grub's tail and using it for a weightless rig, just like a fat senko. Emo technique. Tailless emo grub is designed for such usage out of the box. I have videos introducing emo rigging and tailless emo grub in my library. If you've not yet checked them out, let's check out. This could become your secret technique, since not many anglers in the Western world might have not even seen it. Five sizes are available: 30, 40, 50, 60, and 90 millimeters. This is the biggest 90mm sized worm. Can be a great bait for summertime copper fishing. Okay, the next one is from Kimco. Another Gary Yamamoto retailer in Japan. They made this their original unique worm for the very Japanese finesse style fishing. Gary Yamamoto Silk Worm. Only 2 inches of small weight. Kimco said, "This worm is very good as a jig trailer, but also fine to use standalone. Super effective for smallmouth bass." Oh yeah, I agree, this can be a killer bait for small reeds. They said, "This is very small, but this grabs the water and makes great action. Small and compact, but has enough presence in the water." Kimco said they designed this worm using Gary materials based on such concepts. A flatback grub body with a concave thin waist. A big tail with twin fins. A very interesting shape. I have never tried this lure. Okay, let me purchase it. A lightweight jig head, a small rubber jig, split shot, drop shot, nose hook setup with a small nail weight. I cannot wait to try this lure. Hope this works for American largemouths as well. Oh yes, senko, yamasenko. Needless to say, the world famous soft baits, the biggest invention Gary Yamamoto ever made. We can find so many senko clones, but the original one is a masterpiece like no other. This is 2 inches yamasenko. 2 inches, very small, not available in the United States. Yeah, I don't think American anglers buy this, since this is too small, but the Japanese do. This lure is known as a killer bait for heavily pressured spots. When fish get so nervous not easily using their mouth, it's time for this. This tiny simple stick could work for such a situation. Although bluegill and other panfish also love this. They often make a bite before bass makes it. This is 3.5 inches Yamamimizu, produced by Tsuguhiko Komori. A knot worm shaped worm made of Gary material. As we all know, Gary Yamamoto's worm material is something special, which can give the artificial bait a real life. Yamamimizu, mimizu, is a knot worm in Japanese. Earthworms are a common bait for any fish. Big, thick, stinky ones are great baits for big fish. I think these days a straight but non-tapered shaped worm has been trending. I can see some other brands also have produced a similar type of worms. Anyway, the reason why non-tapered shape? When we use this with Waki rigging, we'll transmit the same power volume to both sides, the head and the tail. As a result, the entire body can have a big but natural action that beckons fish. It would look like a huge earthworm twisting in the water. Weightless Waki, Neko rig, jig head, and maybe Waki rig drop shot could be the primary options for this worm. I personally like short-range cover fishing using this kind of bait with bait finesse system, although I'm not sure if this lure can be greater than my favorite rig shake or not. Would be worth giving it a shot. This one is also produced by Tsuguhiko Komori. Gary Yamamoto Mercury Claw. A flat body with big arms. This flat main body could provide better hooking capability. The two big claws would make a complex water current turbulence, which would be this worm's most powerful feature. So, Mr. Komori says, good for cover fishing, but not just for it. To maximize this lure's potential, how to fish in the mid-range with swimming action would be key. Would be good with Texas rig, jig, reel rig, and weightless rig. Only one size, 3.8 inches, is available. Yeah. This looks good. I did not buy this, but after checking out the spec, I'd love to use this. Next time when I go to Japan, I'll get one for sure. Gary Yamamoto Angry Stick. A round shot-shaped body with a long pin tail. Only 3 inches long. Could look like Death's Death Adder. Or I could say Yamamoto Shadow Shape Worm variant. Oh, by the way, this is by Gary International. Shadow Shape Worm is made by Timco. Anyway, this worm, honestly say, my type. Let's throw it with a small jig head, or nose-hooked weightless rig would be a good match. Split shot and light Carolina rig can be other options. Yeah, like Death Adder. This would be well fitting to my bait finesse system bass fishing. This is Gary Yamamoto, Detroiter, produced by Daisuke Aoki. Daisuke Aoki, ex-Bassmaster Elite Pro. Like other Japanese bass pros, he's very good at finesse-style fishing. This lure is made for a finesse jig trailer. In Japan, a small rubber jig is a super popular rig. When I moved to the United States 10 years ago, I was surprised I could not find any of them in tackle shops. What the hell? Anyway, Detroiter, 2.4 inches, small crustacean type bait. The two long tentacles have ribs. With certain actions, we can give them a lifelike motion. The two arms also flutter when we give shaking actions. Looks great! The finesse rig is great for bait finesse system. So that a big trend of finesse jig might be coming soon in the United States. Maybe. Hagar, an ex-Bassmaster Elite Pro Ken Iobi produced this. A crow-type bait, which is designed specifically for a backslide action with reverse rigging. Oh yeah, crowfish swims backward, right? A heavy salty material body can produce long distance castability and also give it a long backslide distance. The total length is 4.4 inches with long arms. This could be a far-reaching alternative. Other companies like Jackal also have a similar type of bait, but being made of Gary soft lure material is somewhat attractive for me. Maybe I should have got one? Okay, the last one in this video is Cattail Worm. I love it. This is a standard lure from the Gary Yamamoto brand. So many lovers like me are in Japan. Look at this. Various sizes and colors of cattail worms are on sale. I believe you can see how much this lure is loved by people in Japan. For any reason, not much popular in the United States. I have no idea why. Maybe there are a few anglers who fish in the finesse style? This lure is good for any type of finesse rig. Of course, bigger sizes can be used just like other classic straight worms. I personally recommend purchasing 3.5 inches when you have a chance to come to Japan. Above 4 inches, you would be able to find in the United States, but 3.5 inches is not easy to get there. 3.5 inches with finesse rigs. You'll get a bite right on the first few casts. Haha, that's all today. If you're interested in some of those items, let's check out the internet. Some online sellers might have it. Or make sure that when you go to Japan, hit the local tackle shops. You'll be amazed, for sure. See you! Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Bye bye!